Hi, my name's Neil and I work for the data science team at TIBCO. TIBCO Data Science has launched AutoML, which is an extension to the TIBCO Team Studio product. AutoML reduces the workload on data scientists by providing automation for both features and models. It's delivered as a set of building blocks that can be used as is, it can be tweaked or optimized, or it can even be broken up entirely to be used as reusable modules. Now, this is an excellent example of how extensible the TIBCO Data Science platform is. It's built entirely using standard APIs and extension points that the platform provides. Let's take a look at how this works. This initial workflow calls on the AutoML orchestrator. To the left, you see our input data consisting of insurance customers joined with fraudulent claims and income estimated by zip code. We'll use AutoML here to see if we can predict fraudulent claims from the customer data. In the orchestrator options, we select the dependent column from our data. We can choose if we want to use a shallow or deep model complexity. This choice controls the extent of the hyperparameter search during the predictive modeling phase. A shallow search is quicker and gives a good initial idea of the most suitable model, while a deep search will normally provide more accurate models at the cost of being slower. Running the workflow automates the entire feature engineering and modeling procedures needed here. At the bottom, we see the leaderboard of top scored models and diagnostics. A gradient boosting model is our top performer with an accuracy of about 78%. Other models are shown below. Best model info shows more details on our top model and its resulting parameters, such as the number of trees, depth, and learning rate. We can quickly view the variable important score as well, here showing that income by zip code is the most important variable. Within the AutoML workflow, I can see individual subflows used to create this model. Each of these flows are within my workspace and shown with the URL directly from the workflow results. I can view the subflows directly in my workspace as well. The really cool part about AutoML is that it automatically built each of these subflows on its own with no manual work needed from my end. Let's take a look at the first subflow on data prep. This subflow takes input data from the AutoML orchestrator and goes through cleaning, removing of missing values, and label encoding for the target variable before finally being split into a training and test set. In the feature engineering subflow, predictors are automatically transformed using multiple strategies, allowing the downstream algorithms to train better performing models. Here, weight of evidence and impact encoding are applied to select categorical variables, and normalization is used for continuous variables. Next, for feature selection, stability selection chooses candidate predictors that are likely to have the most predictive power. The modeling subflow takes each of the feature engineering strategies and trains models with random forest, gradient boosting, and regularized logistic regression algorithms across a set of hyperparameters. The results are all compared based on model accuracy to produce the leaderboard results. But what if a data scientist wants to tweak or optimize any of these subflows? They can do so at any time by using TIBCO Team Studio as they would with any other workflow. Resampling nodes can be added, for example, if I want to upsample to account for imbalance in the target variable. After I make the changes I want, I simply return to my orchestrator workflow where I can rerun the flow in each subflow. Briefly reviewing the results, I see that adjusting the imbalances through resampling improves the performance of the random forest model and improves my prediction accuracy to about 79%. So this was a quick view of how AutoML works in Team Studio. If you'd like to learn more, check out the links in the video description. Thanks, and catch you next time.